Hello friend, today I came to know that some rubber parts like capsule, rod centralizer, etc. have very short life and hand pump users are suffering from these common problems. Therefore, I am thinking how to enhance the life of rubber parts and what are the main reason behind the short life of rubber parts. Now I found two factors affecting the life of rubber parts. Factor number one is quality of nitrile rubber. The quality of nitrile rubber should conform to a standard approved by RWSM. Some quality checks like elongation, tensile strength, compression set, sore hardness, volume change, etc. are mentioned in the British standard 2751 approved for hand pump by RWSM. The manufacturer is responsible for supplying the material after checking the quality of rubber as per standard. Now, second point is the assembly point. The straightness and alignment of pump rod, pipes, plunger rod, bore hole, etc. should be checked by the manufacturer as well as by the technician in the field before installation. Now I will show you plunger rod. The plunger rod is checked by gauge whether it is straight or not. Please look at the plunger rod. I am checking it. This plunger rod is straight and it is okay. This plunger rod is also straight. Now third plunger rod, it is bent, and such type of plunger rod should not be installed by the technician in the field. Now the straightness of plunger rod should be checked by the technician manually. I will show you how a technician can check manually without any gauge the straightness of plunger rod. Please look at me, I am checking. When you look at the plunger rod, you can understand it is straight or not. When the plunger rod is bent, it may lead to excessive wear and tear of rubber capsule due to excessive friction, and it will reduce the life of rubber capsule. Next point is straightness of pump rod. Now the straightness of the pump rod should also be checked by gauge. Please look at this gauge. Such a gauge is used by the manufacturer to check the straightness of pump rod. Two pump rods are connected to each other and put in the gauge. This gauge will show you whether the pump rod is straight or not. The straightness of the pump rod should also be checked in the field by technician. Now, I will show you how a technician can check manually the straightness of pump rod. Please, two or three pump rods should be connected to each other. When you rotate the connected pump rod on the level ground, you can understand whether it is straight or not. For example, this is bent pump rod. Look at this, how it is rotated to understand the straightness. Third point is rod hanger. At present, I have two rod hanger. Please look at this rod hanger. Position of the hole should be at the center. This hole is exactly at the center of rod hanger. And it is okay. But look at this rod hanger. Hole is not at the center. Hole is out of the center. And it is rejected. If the hole of rod hanger is out of center or pump rod is not straight, then rod centralizer may come in contact with pipe and It leads to excessive wear and tear due to unnecessary friction. It will reduce the life of rod centralizer, and therefore, before installation, a perfect technician, an expert technician, should check the straightness of pump rod, plunger rod, pipe, alignment of bore holes, etc. Thus, at last, I want to say you only two factors. Factor number one, quality of rubber component should conform to a standard issued by RWSN. Point number two, the alignment and the straightness of pump rod, plunger rod, pipe, bore hole, etc. Thank you. Bye-bye.